dear friends and colleagues, be welcome to Romanian Embassy in Canberra. I'm delighted you join me and them for celebrating National Day of Romania. Allow me, I will be MC, which is of course much better for Romanian government, since they don't pay two persons to do same performance. But don't share this necessarily as a best practice. Anyway, thank you very much. Thank you, Madam Linda Sachs, for being here today. So let's start the formal part of our ceremony. Your Excellency, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, it's my honor to propose a toast to the President and the people of Romania. She's not a Romanian lady. Long story later for Le Connoisseur. I'm delighted to make a toast for the Queen and the people of Australia. How many pages I have? That's the bad news. No. And I don't want to share the size of the fonts. So, Chief of Protocol, Madam Linda Sachs, Deans of the Latin American countries, of Arab countries, and the female heads of missions, colleague ambassadors and high commissioners, representative of the Department of Foreign Affairs and Trade, thank you, Daniel, as usual. Members of the Rotary Club in Canberra, friends of Romania, dragi români. I thank you all for joining me and my husband Dan for celebrating 2016 Romanian National Day. I would like to acknowledge the presence of Romanians coming from New Zealand, our newly appointed honorary consul in New Zealand, Mr. Mariani Wan, might be somewhere. Yes. Thank you for coming from New Zealand. There's no direct flight. Yes, not yet. We are paid to be optimists. From South Australia, Mrs. Liliana Stoian, her husband, and Madam Dorina Mikash, somewhere here. Thank you very much. Thank you. Many more nationals from other Australian states, such as New South Wales, Mr. George Roca and his lovely wife, somewhere.
Here.
Thank you for coming from Sydney, not too far away, but it's important that you are here. And also Mrs. Cornelia Skinte and Mr. Matej Skinte from Covasna, Romania. Thank you very much for coming up to Australia.
Thank you very much.
For no. This very special, not direct flight as well. Fiți bineveniți la Ambasada României de la Canberra și mulțumesc pentru bucuria de a fi împreună cu ocazia celebrării Zilei Naționale a României la Canberra, cea mai importantă sărbătoare anuală a României și a românilor din toată lumea. My dear friends, distinguished guests, I prepared for you very short stories about Romanians, what else? First is a historic story about almost 480,000 Romanian heroes, our casualties from the First World War. Romania joined the Antanta coalition in 1916. In 1917, Romania has to face the invasion of half of our territory and an epidemic of typhus, plus the outbreak of the Bolshevik Revolution on its doorstep. Romania has Queen Maria of Romania, the mother of wounded, did her best to encourage and motivate Romanians, going to the front, caring for the wounded, and acting on behalf of Romanian Red Cross, serving as a humble nurse. In Chișinău on April 19, 1918, in Cernăuți on November 28, and in Alba Iulia on December 1st of December 1918, God bless you, Cadoreniu, it's homolog. Millions of Romanians from Basarabia, Bukovina, and Transylvania declared unanimously the union of these three free provinces with the motherland, the Kingdom of Romania. On December 11, King Ferdinand I promulgated a decree that approved the Great Union. The Kingdom of Romania doubled in size and in population. The peace treaties with Germany, Bulgaria, Austria, and Hungary recognized the union of all Romanians. The Great Union is a long-cherished national aspiration for unity, the foremost event in Romania's history for more than 2,000 years. King Michael I, aged now 95, is the sons, one of the sons of Queen Maria of Romania. He's living in Romania currently since 1995, the last king of our country and the only head of state survivor from the Second World War. This wall in front of me, shaping Romanian borders, humbly speaks about Romanian heroes and the contributions of the royal family to the Great Union, their lives during the war, and remembering them is so profoundly important. It's just like a heaven for them. Romanian Great War in the sound of violin, lest we forget. My second story, distinguished guest, is about Romanian divine ingenuity. Two outstanding Romanian artists from Covasna, Cornelia and Matej Skinte. Who is Cornelia? Yes, Madame Cornelia Skinte and Matej Skinte came straight from Romania to Australia. This is a repetition. And are here with us today. I would like to express my deepest and my heartfelt gratitude for their gesture to come and present beautiful and present to us beautiful divine icons. Please indulge your eyes and your souls with authentic Romanian art created by this very special artist. In Romania, in Australian understanding of this adverb, near Covasna, is the city of Timișoara. How many kilometers? Covasna, Timișoara, roughly. That is near, in Australia is near. It's just right before, you know, next to your house. So near is the city of Timișoara, and this has been nominated, Timișoara has been nominated as European Cultural Capital, and we are very pleased to speak about it. Now this leads me to my third short story. Speaking about the added value of Romanian innovation, this is actually, this is a repetition for some of them, please, I have to apologize, but we have at least three, four new colleagues, ambassador around us, so they didn't hear that. Just arrived in Canberra on April 28 in Hobart, Tasmania, when the Honorable Julie Bishop, Minister of Foreign Affairs of Australia, and the Honorable Greg Hunt, Minister of Environment, duly signed a beautiful contract for the building of the next Australia's icebreaker in Romania, Galați, my native town, by shipyards, Damen Shipyards, which is a company owned by a Dutch private company. And Serco, the Australian contractor, was very kind to ship from Sydney to our embassy in Canberra. This almost model is somewhere there. It's big enough to be noticed. Almost the model of the future icebreaker, really the next generation of scientific research in Antarctica. The icebreaker, by the way, Australia should find, I mean, will find it a name, will be spectacular, 178 meters long, serviced by a fleet of 4 helicopters and more than 130 scientists on board. It will be delivered at Hobart for Australia Antarctic Division in 2019. I might not be here, but if you are here, please remember this very beautiful moment. After all, we Romanians are sharing National Day of Romania, which is 1st of December, with Antarctica, because maybe countries which are state parties to Antarctica Treaty, 1st of December, yesterday was also International Day of Antarctica. So there might be a reason why we are building this icebreaker. Now, the next story, this year we are celebrating here in Australia and in New Zealand Romanian National Day with a special focus on Romanian creativity. I'm organizing this Sunday the very first festival of Romanian genius creativity, gathering many books written by Romanians living in this part of the world, writers, translators, painters, such as Madame Dorina Micaș from Adelaide, or Valentin D'Angelo, Romanian painter from New Zealand. Three of these his paintings are in the opposite corner of the room, there, these three. These are images from New Zealand. Those of you who are credited in New Zealand might recognize the place, Raritopa. And we will have photographers such as Constantin Brăcuș, the patriarch of modern sculpture and the creator of the bird in space, the most valuable foreign masterpiece here in Australia, at the National Gallery of Australia in Canberra. A beautiful coincidence is that the future skyscraper in Melbourne, precisely it will be at 295 King Street, inspired by Bird in Space, was approved mid-February 2016, precisely when we celebrated in this very room, prior to being refurbished, by the way, Constantin Brâncuș's birthday, his muses, his masterpieces, on February 19, and in the same day, I was not aware at that stage, it was the local council in Melbourne announced this future building. And this is a beautiful coincidence, and I wanted to share with you. On walls, you may see on these two screens, two TV, four short videos recorded by Brâncuș himself in Paris between the two world wars. You are all welcome this Sunday, starting at 11 till late night, to immerse into local Romanian sound. Last but not least at all, and of course coming back to more serious issues of universal urgency and interest, you all might know that number three WTA, Simona Halep, I know there are many tennis players among us, has an Aussie trainer, Mr. Darren Cahill. So now we might be sure that we have someone to blame if things will not happen as expected during the next Australian Open in January. Now, at the end, I would like to thank in particular to the distinguished representative of the Department of Foreign Affairs and the Trade for doing their utmost for our bilateral relations with Australia, in particular for the establishing next year of a permanent consular office in Melbourne and for opening the very first Romanian honorary consulate in Adelaide and in Perth next year as well. And since 2016 seems to be the year of turning around upon elections or referendum, of course this country, Australia, being maybe the most notable exception, please wish me luck on December 11, when Romanians everywhere, in Romania and everywhere, including in Australia and New Zealand, will vote for our parliamentary elections, in particular in Adelaide, Brisbane, Canberra, Melbourne, Perth, and Sydney. It's an alphabetical order. There are people from Sydney, they are very sensitive, usual. And from Melbourne, they're more sensitive. So no, it's just alphabetical order. And also Romanians will vote in Auckland. It's important because, well, there are voting process everywhere, electoral process, but it's the first time Romanians will have the opportunity of voting by mail, which seems to be cheap and very affordable when you are at least far away from country, you know. So starting with January, I can provide lessons learned how not to handle this. Thank you, of course, Dan and our beloved children. Be strong, happy, and visionary. And for the very small, yet very ambitious team at the embassy in Canberra, Nicolae family, Mihaela and Laurențiu, thank you for your dedicated work and passion, and all the best for incoming year. Please enjoy Romanian traditional dishes made in house, as usual, by Madame Lina Cuzia. Pentru conaționalii mei, nu uitați să gândiți, să vorbiți, să scrieți și să cântați românește. La mulți ani românilor de pretutindeni. Happy Christmas to everybody, a Happy New Year 2017. Make a wish, it may happen eventually. Enjoy the rest of the evening. Thank you very much for being here. Thank you.
Camera.